Hello, sir.
Great.
I have unmuted you, sir.
You unmuted me. How many total participants are there? 434.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Record the session. Total session.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right. So we'll wait another 2-3 minutes for all others to join.
Okay, sir.
Meanwhile, we'll go ahead with one poll. That poll is just you type in the chat if you want to join in Infosys, if you want to join in Wipro, if you want to join in TCS, if you want to join in CTS. If you are not having any option in your hand, whatever company you want to join, just type in that chat box. If you are not having any job, put NS. NS is the symbol for non-select, right? Do that one in I'm giving you 1 minute time, so please do that. Meanwhile, we'll wait others to join. Yeah, good. So many people expressed your views. And second question to you all. In the present situation, how many of you are feeling that your offer will be secured? If you are thinking that your offer will be secured, just type one. If your offer is not secured, you are under the impression that your offer is not secured, type two. Yeah, many people are positive. Many people are under the impression that your offer is secured. That is good. Go ahead. At present, 568, 570 logins are there. 571. This meeting allows 1,000 students, no problem. If anybody wants to join, still they can join. How many of you are under the impression that offer given to GVP is more secure than other colleges? If your answer is yes, say yes. No, you can say no. This is the third poll. Third poll is, if you are under the impression that the offer you got it through GVP is secured, compare it to other institutes, say yes. If you are not thinking that your offer is not secure, just type no. Just a warming up exercise I am doing, okay? Fastest fingers, your younger generation. So I asked her three questions. The first question is, what is your company? Which company you choosing to join? That is the number one. Number two, I asked you whether your offer is secured or not. And number three, offer got it through GVP secured, compare it to other colleges. That is the three questions. So my voice is poor. Are you able to listen? Just raise your hand, some people. Is it audible? Yeah. So if I'm not audible, most probably your device audio is in little low. You can increase the volume of your device also, right? How many of your, this is a very important valid poll question. How many of you are under the impression that your batching gates will be delayed? If you are thinking your batching gates will be delayed, press 1. If your batching gates will be on par, means like your seniors in the month of June, July, August, if it is on par, press 1. If you are under the impression it is delayed, press 2. Eleven means what? Somebody type 11. There is a option 1 and 2 only. There is no 11 option. Let me see the count now. 630 students participated. So we can start the session. Before starting the session, the final question. If you say yes, you should type S in capital letters. If you are no, also in the capital letters. Whether this corona is going to affect our career goals or not. Whether this corona is going to affect your career goals. Yeah, with this, this is the warm up session. Most probably today my talk is around all these questions only. Meanwhile, I welcome Krishna Subbarao, sir. He is online, CSCHOD. And I am seeing Narasimha Rao, sir, from EEE department online. They also wants to share the things with you. Yeah. So with these things, we will start this session. This session is known as the review of post-offer connect activities and even some questions relating to the upcoming off-campus, school campus, whatever future opportunities. I'll take that questions also. Number one, I want to start this entire session with one small story. The story is like this. A lioness is there. The lioness is a pregnant lioness. You know, the lioness pregnancy will be there from 180 days to 120 days to 150 days, 4 to 5 months before delivering the baby. So this lioness always after getting the pregnancy, it hides. herself. So like that one lioness in one deep forest hided herself in one cave. So many days she is not having sufficient food. So the lioness had to deliver a baby cub. Most probably at any minute she delivers a baby. But the lioness is too hungry. She was not taken sufficient food from so many days. Then lioness slowly came out from the cave, started standing on a rock on the hill and seeing is there anything she can eat. So down the valley, one sheep group is going. So the lioness is so happy. She wanted to eat one sheep and satisfy her hungerness. Immediately when the sheep group came nearer to that particular hill, she jumped on the hill on the center of this sheep group. The moment the lioness not calculated the height of this hill and the sheep group, the moment she landed on the sheep group, she delivered a cub and died. Unfortunate thing, the cub woke up without seeing the mother alive, and the cub started walking along with the remaining sheep. And slowly the cub started growing along with the sheep, started behaving like a sheep, started eating grass, etc. So she is almost all a different shape sheep. It is not like a lion. So one day what happened, a lion from forest came to attack this sheep group. Then this lion came from forest, saw one animal similar to lion but living in sheep's group with almost like a sheep behavior. Then the lion from forest surprised. This lion who grown up along with sheep's group, it is almost all behaving like a sheep, talking like a sheep, eating grass, etc. Then this lion from forest take this lion and the sheep group to a water pond. And in water pond shown her that image, shown the lion, the image of lion. So you are not a sheep, you are a lion. So you should behave like me, not like sheep. You should start eat non-vegetarian, not grass, etc. Then slowly this lion who grown in this sheep group started believing that she is a lion and started roaring like lion, etc. So the bottom of the story is this effect in the management, we will call it as conditioning effect. Conditioning effect means in the group, whatever people will do, we will do that only. If all the people talks about corona and its impact, we will talk and we will believe that only. If all the people talks about cricket, we will talk and we will live in that particular mood only. If all people are talking about losing the jobs, we are not having any jobs, even the employees who are working in US, they'll come back to India, forget about our jobs, even our seniors won't get the jobs. This if you are tuned to this mentality, this is known as a conditioning effect. So first of all, you want to learn anything, you should come out from the conditioning effect. You want me to quote one more example? I'll quote this example in Telugu. There is a hill called Mahendragiri in the border of Andhra Pradesh and Orissa. Andhra Pradesh Orissa lo oka border lo oka Mahendragiri ano hill undi. Aa hill meeda oka yenugulu penchatunu oka athunu baby elephants ni teeskochi vaatini groom chesi penchutu untadu. Oka baby elephant ni teeskochadu athunu. తీసుకొచ్చి పెంచడం మొదలు పెట్టాడు. బేబీ ఎలిఫెంట్ తీసుకొచ్చినప్పుడు ఒక చిన్న పోల్కి దాన్ని కట్టేశాడు, ఒక చిన్న గడ్డితో నేసిన ఒక తాడుతోటి. అది ఎలిఫెంట్ చిన్నగా ఉన్నప్పుడు ఆ తాడు తెంపలేదు, ఆ పోల్ని పైకి లాగలేదు. కానీ ఎలిఫెంట్ స్టార్టెడ్ గ్రోయింగ్ అప్ ద బేబీ ఎలిఫెంట్ గ్రోన్ అప్ అండ్ బికమ్ ఫుల్ సైజ్ ఎలిఫెంట్. ఇప్పుడు ఏం చేయొచ్చు, ఈ తాడును తెంపేయచ్చు, పోలును లాగచ్చు, కానీ అది లాగట్లేదు, అది తెంపట్లేదు. ఎందుకంటే దానికి ఒక కండిషనింగ్ ఎఫెక్ట్ ట్యూన్ అయిపోయింది. ఏంటంటే ఈ తాడును నేను తెంపలేను, ఈ పోలును నేను పేకలేను అని చెప్పి. సో దట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ వన్ మోర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆఫ్ కండిషనింగ్ ఎఫెక్ట్. నాట్ ఓన్లీ యూ, వీఆర్ ఆల్ ఇన్ కండిషనింగ్ ఎఫెక్ట్. మనం అందరూ ఏమనుకుంటున్నాం అంటే లాస్ట్ 14-15 డేస్ నుంచి అయ్య బాబు ఏదేదో మనం వచ్చేసి చాలా ప్రాబ్లంలో ఉన్నాము, మనం అందరం కూడా we are going to be in this corona and రోజు దాని స్టాటిస్టిక్స్ దాని యొక్క ఇది చూసేసి ఇచ్చేసేస్తాం. సి ఇఫ్ యూ సీ ద స్టాటిస్టిక్స్ ఇమ్యూనిటీ పవర్ ఈజ్ ద మేజర్ రిసోర్స్ మేజర్ థింగ్ టు ప్రొటెక్ట్ అస్ ఫ్రమ్ ది కరోనా. యువర్ నో ప్రాబ్లమ్ అలా అని చెప్పి మిమ్మల్ని చేయమంటలేదు, బయటకు తనతో కలవమని చెప్పట్లేదు. స్టే హోమ్, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ సజెస్టింగ్ యూ టు చెక్ యువర్ ఇమ్యూనిటీ ఇమీడియట్లీ గోయింగ్ అవుట్ అండ్ గివింగ్ షేక్ హ్యాండ్ టు సో మెనీ పీపుల్. ఐఎమ్ నాట్ టెలింగ్ దట్. వాట్ ఐఎమ్ టెలింగ్ టు యూ ఈజ్ డోంట్ థింక్ అబౌట్ వాట్ ఈస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్, డోంట్ ఫాలో ద న్యూస్ సో ఫ్రీక్వెంట్లీ, డైలీ వన్స్ ఓకే. But don't follow what is happening in that area, this area, and so many rumors are coming. Don't believe it. But start believing yourself and start doing something related to your career aspirations. Until and unless you do career, start doing career related activities, it is very difficult to get back. No. Batching dates will be delayed or not? Yes, batching dates will be delayed. That is the first answer. So, why it is delayed? Number one, your examinations are pending. Project reviews are pending. So, definitely will be possible after the institutions may open according to everyone's guess and everyone's prediction. It will be open after June 15th only. That is, or in a best case after May 15th, in a worst case after June 15th, only education institutions will be reopened. After reopening, we can conduct your final examination, we can conduct your final project reviews. Meanwhile, the project reviews may be finished through online remaining, but final review will be with external examiner presence. That will be only possible after the lockdown effect. Therefore, instead of completing entire cycle in the month of April, we are completing entire cycle in the month of June. So it is clearly clear evidence that so your schedule is going to be delayed by 2 to 1.5 months. So this leads definitely, if any company asking us what is your last working day, most probably we will give the last working day after lockdown. 1 week time we require. After lockdown, we will finish entire thing in 1 week and we will relieve our final year students. That is the answer from our side. Okay. So therefore, definitely there will be a 2 to 3 months, 2 to 3 months delay there from academic side to give your BTech degree. But some companies may ask you to come early by taking course completion certificate with the pending of project, etc. In 2-3 years back, one company has emergency requirement. They said we want immediately whomsoever we selected. At that time, we take a special resolution and we send the people with one letter, that is, they should come and complete their project review, project viva and review, etc. That is also possible. If that case appears, definitely the college is going to support you. Don't worry about it. We don't want to stop you to join in any company. We will see all alternatives possible to do it. But remember one thing, not that easy, because the travel restrictions will continue. Not that easy to get the batching dates early. So first, I want to tell the impact first to give full clarity to you. And then I'll talk on each and every issue. Then finally, I'll take a question. So, Girish, can you show up the presentation in the screen? Yeah, this is the, can you show it in a full?
Sir, is it visible, sir?
Yeah, it is.
Yes, sir.
Some of my settings on post offer connect activities. If any students who are not having any offer, don't think that this is not useful to you. definitely this is useful to you. Whatever these people are doing, you also do it. Definitely you will get a fair chance of getting the batching list, right? So this session is called as review on post offer connect activities. This session agenda is like this. Next slide, please. First, I want to cover about the present situation and its impact. And then I want to cover participation in post offer connect activities. I want to stretch on TCS Explore, remote internship, Infosys InfyTQ, Infosys Lex platform, completion of Wipro registrations, CTS internship, and Amazon assignments, and all the things. Learning latest tools and technologies, doing certification courses. This I want to discuss with you. Finally, I want to answer if any questions I am able to answer from my side or my team, and HODs also be there in the online. They'll also answer some of your questions. So go to the first topic, that is about the present situation and its impact. Girish, show the next slide. So if you are following the newspapers and online news available to you, India's GDP growth for the current fiscal year is expected to slow down 4.8%. This is a UN report, United Nations report, but recently Barclay, which is a financial company of UK, they declared that they estimated that the India's GDP growth is going to fall down to 2.8%. So here 4.8%, UN is a little optimistic, but Barclay given a very good, you can go to the Google and see the Barclay article, and it is clearly showing with the good number of statistics that India's GDP is coming going to come down to 2.8 from the estimation of 5. That means 2.2%. Half of the GDP estimation this year, it is coming down because of the situation of lockdown. So you know, if you are following the news channels regularly, KCR given one example about Telangana state. Telangana state every day's revenue is 400 crores. Now it came down to 4 crores to 6 crores. So it is clearly a clear impact that if one state 400 crores per day is losing, so all over India, how much they are going to lose, you just estimate. Some people are telling India is going to lose 9 lakhs crores, right? That estimation, so we'll take it a little later. And economic growth rate is also decreased from 7% to 5%, and further decline is also possible. Particularly, GDP growth for the current quarter up and down to 4%, but I am estimating it will drop down. If lockdown is extended another 2-3 weeks, it is going to be dropped down to, as Barclay said, 2.8% to 3%. So if GDP comes down, you know, GDP is a GDP is a combination of GDP from three sectors. One is agriculture sector, second one is manufacturing sector, third one is service sector. So agriculture sector, from last 30-40 days, how it is affected because of lockdown situation, you know. And manufacturing sector, almost all the companies are closed down, and they are not at all working. So therefore, the manufacturing sector, whatever it is contributing, it is also declined. And service sector, you know, except some services like cloud services, like this Zoom meetings, There are so many service sector companies like hospitality industry, like tourism industry, like travel industry. And I want to give one example. 4 days back, I discussed with one senior person in GMR group, who is a manager in GMR airports. What he is telling to me, one day airport closes, the loss they can recover, that loss occurred because of 1 month close down of the airport. It takes 1 month to recover. So 21 days lockdown is there. So in order to recover these losses, it requires 21 months if the passengers travel with full flow. That is one example I am giving it to you. Therefore, travel sector, hospitality sector, transport sector, whatever sector you call it as, all the sectors are going to affect because of this situation. Therefore, economic growth rate, GDP, in GDP also service sector GDP, manufacturing sector GDP and agriculture sector GDP is, it comes down like anything, right? Therefore, it leads to the, decline in economic growth. If economic growth is declined, you know, it's a very big problem. Businesses will affect like anything. How many businesses are affecting in which way they get affected, I will show it in my next slide.
Sir, I guess your internet is...
My internet is little slow. Just wait for 1 minute. I am changing my internet provider. Just give me 1 minute time.
Okay, sir.
Now it is okay now? Still problem is there.
No, sir. It is okay.
Can you show the next slide then?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, in India, 53% of businesses will be affected due to COVID-19. So very good study done by one economist, and he is telling, I quoted some examples like hospitality transport industry, travel industry, etc. Indian software industry is going to affect with a loss of 2 to 7% in its revenues. Seeing the effect, they immediately changed the estimations. They said 2 to 7% minimum to maximum 7% revenue will be affected. But Accenture immediately came out after this lockdown. They adjusted their revenue. Minimum loss will be 6%. Maximum loss will be 8%. That means now you can calculate each and every company. Minimum they are going to lose 8%. If 8% revenue they lose, how they will accommodate freshers, how many cost cutting measurements they are going to do. So see the said
Sir, sorry for interrupting. Your voice is breaking, sir.
Slow down. Not only both hands idea. It will little freeze. One analysis in soft.
Sir, I guess you got disconnected again. Please all of you wait for a few minutes. He's going to attend. I think sir is having some internet problem.
Yeah, now are you able to listen? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is it audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So if you go down to the left-hand side bottom, in the near future, IT companies could feel that heat of pricing pressure. That means all the companies, particularly IT companies, used to get the business from US, UK, and Europe, some countries. All these are all going to negotiate a lot with IT companies. Therefore, they are going to get a lot of pricing issues. The companies are not ready to give same. The clients are not ready to give the same price what they given earlier because of their economic impact. Am I audible? Girish, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yeah. Yeah, if you see, very good thing, very bad thing is client bankruptcy. I mentioned in the left-hand side bottom, there is a word called client bankruptcy. I want to elaborate, I want to take off minute on this particular thing. All software companies are expecting 20 to 30% of their clients in US, UK and Europe going to become bankrupt because of this situation. So if they became bankrupt, there is no business from them. Not only business from them, they may not be able to pay old dues also. That will further impact all these software companies. So this is the estimation from ICICI Direct. So therefore, students, number one, the revenue loss will be there because of no new projects. Two, pricing issues all the IT companies are going to face after this COVID. Three, so many clients will become bankrupt that because of that, lot of bad debts will be there for the IT companies. Therefore, their revenue will be drastically declined, not 8%. I am estimating by the last quarter of 2020, that is September to December quarter, a lot of problem is there for the service companies. Therefore, I am not telling all the facts to threaten you. All the facts why I am telling to you, it is very important you should know all these facts, then only you can prepare well to face the situation. So this is the total situation. What is the impact of this situation? Now I will show it in the next slide, please. The impact is delay in batching schedules. So the batching period is earlier June 1st to September 15th, we are used to get most of our selected students used to get the offers. If you take your seniors batch, 2019 batch, some companies started giving from May 15th and almost all the students got by September 15th their batching dates. But for your batch, this batching dates will be a little bit delayed. The delay is because of lack of clarity of business. If you want one example, 3 days back, I spoke with one senior HR. I don't want to give the name here because this session is recording. So I don't want to give his name and the company name also. The senior HR of that company said, sir, they asked us to prepare for off-campus recruitment of 2020 batch. We prepared everything. And not only off-campus, they already said to us, start giving batching dates from June 1st to all the students who completed their post offer connect activities. So therefore we started working on that particular platform. But recently, just 4 days back, we got a news: stop all off-campus recruitment, number one. Number two, batching dates also, there will be a slight change in the batching date schedule. At present, keep that batching date schedule also in a separate folder. Don't release anything. So it is clearly indicating that so the batching dates going to delay, and further the companies are not interested to take any number from your batch, any further number from your batch through off-campus. Earlier we have a lot of off-campus requirements used to come in the month of April, May, June from all reputed companies. So in that also we used to place around 60-70 students to off-campus whomsoever not got any offer, but the situation is not like that. And reduction in number of second point, I underlined the second point for all your reference only. Reduction in number of freshers with post offer assessments. Earlier what they used to do, if TCS, if you are completed the explore, they use it to give the batching dates, or they use it to if you completed the remote internship, they use it to give direct batching dates. But now in the same way, Infosys, if you are in the Lex platform and you completed the Lex, they use it to give it. And all other companies, Wipro also, through Talent Next portal and everything, they use it to give the offers immediately after your fourth semester. But now they may. In 2008 recession, what happened? I want to bring that into your reference. In 2008, what happened? Great software companies faced a lot of recession. In order to give the batching dates, what they have done, so many companies, they increased the process flow. That means one more exam they conducted. Like Tech Mahindra, at that time, they conducted one more exam for the selector. So you are under the impression that you got the selection offer, they'll directly give a batching date to you. But the situation is they may come and ask you to write one more exam. That may be possible. Okay. So you should prepare. You should not relax. You should prepare for that. What that little bit increase in the process flow, one more step they may add to give the batching dates to you. Or maybe HCL, I know very well. In 2009, they given the offer letters. 2008 end, they given the offer letters, and they validated the offer letters in 2010 March. 2008 end, they given the offer letters. They validated the offer letters in 2010 March. That means they delayed 15 months to batch the students. Therefore, you should prepare for all the things. So you should choose a company which is giving immediate offer letters to you, right? And the third point is, I'll quickly move on, because you know now this time what I am telling, what is my mind and what is the mind of the everyone, you are able to understand now. Startup recruitments may come down drastically because of decline of clientele base. So startup recruitment may not be there. And I want to suggest one thing here: if you are having any startup offer, try to verify twice, thrice before joining in the startup, because the startups may not have the long run capability of running the business. If they are not having cash flow for 6-7 months, they may not be able to run the business in the long run. Therefore, that you should keep it in your mind. If you are having a startup offer, verify twice or thrice before joining, before accepting the startup company offer. There is a possibility after you join, within 3-4 months, the company may be wind it up. So therefore, your career is going, you are going to lose your career. So if you are having any startup company offer, verify twice, thrice the capability of financial capability of that company, then only you join in that particular process. Stringent process flow in batching. I already covered this point. They may ask you to write one more exam, or they may give some assignments to you. If you finish that assignment, they'll give the batching dates. If you are not finishing that assignment, they won't give the batching dates. That possibility is also there. And comes to the fifth point, developing programming skills, at least in one programming. particularly this point, I wrote it here for the non-CS IT students who got the IT company offer. Students from mechanical, triple E and ECE, if you are not good at or maybe other civil, chemical branches, if you are not good in any programming language, any one program I mentioned, any one programming language I mentioned here, please try to develop. Don't waste your time. Try to develop any one programming language, either C, C++, Java, SQL, JavaScript, or Python. So these are all very much required. So if you are having you are not 100% confident in any programming language, try to fill the gaps. Try to be ready with knowing everything in that particular programming language. And the next point is very important. Major project plays a vital role. Why major projects say major project plays a vital role? Most probably one more round of interview they will conduct to you. Shall I repeat? I want to repeat one thing. There probably before giving batching dates, one more telephonic round of interview probably may be there for all of you from the companies which selected you. Therefore, do your major project sincerely. Then why I pointed out on conditioning effect, I observed so many people, so many students from your batch and your juniors batch, they are not doing anything, just they are killing the time, doing busy in mobile games, etc. Wasting your time, you are not doing anything. So my point over here is, if you are not doing anything, it is very difficult to get the batching dates. Therefore, first responsibility on your shoulder, you should complete your major project with lots and lots of sincerity. Be in touch with your faculty mentors. Be in touch with your HODs. Try to finish your major projects as quickly as possible. If a project is given to four members, all four members must be active. One person is doing and remaining two, three people are not doing. Two people are doing, not remaining two, three people are, remaining two are not doing. It is not going to be a right sign. Therefore, what I request you all four members, whatever project allotted to you, you should take it seriously. You should be in touch with your faculty guides, faculty mentors, and you should be in touch with your HODs. Try to complete the major project quickly with good quality on latest topics, because there will be another interview. In that interview, definitely they're going to ask you the first and very important question: how you spent your lockdown period. You should answer this question. Sir, I watch a TV, or maybe I am busy in mobile games, etc. Or you should tell some good up answer. They are not going to listen. Therefore, my dear students, so you should finish your major project quickly with quality, and you should be ready to answer the question in such a way that, sir, in the lockdown period, I developed my major project. Actually, I'm not having earlier much time to develop my major project in a nice way. This time allowed me to do my project elaboratively. Not only these tools, I used these tools and these technologies. Like that, you are supposed to give answer. So therefore, I request all of you, please concentrate on your major research project, right? Major project. And if anybody not having any offer is here, my sincere suggestion to you, the off-campus actually, there will be already we got news from two major companies that they are going to conduct the off-campus in the month of May. But now that situation may not be there. So off-campus recruitment may not be there. Therefore, you should start thinking about various other alternatives, like concentrating on higher education opportunities, or concentrating on hackathon-based hirings by software companies, are concentrating on your post graduation, because this period will be required to come out from this particular situation. Meanwhile, I request you to complete your Am I audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Yeah. Meanwhile, what you are supposed to do, you can finish your M.Tech. Therefore, if anybody is not having a concrete offer in your hand, prepare for the off-campuses, school campuses, but that opportunities may be limited. Therefore, just to change your career planning, try to do these 2 years, coming 2 years, M.Tech in a reputed college or maybe MBA like that. I prefer always M.Tech rather than MBA. So if any one of you not having any placement offer till now, my sincere suggestion, write PGSET or do something, just alter your career objective. Next 2 years, do a M.Tech program or a certification programs like that. And I am seeing a positive thing. Maybe two sectors will definitely improve after this COVID effect. One is health infrastructure sector will definitely going to improve. Lots and lots of budgets will be there. So many hospitals will be constructed. Lot of medical equipment manufacturing will be increased. Therefore, some electronics engineers will get an opportunity in these areas. And civil infrastructure projects will be increased like anything. Any recession, after any recession, the governments will invest a lot of money on infrastructure development. I am seeing two positives. One, health infrastructure will be improved. Some electronics engineers will get a job in it. And civil infrastructure will be also developed. That also will be possible. And the third one is pharmaceutical and bulk drug industry will increase like anything after this COVID-19. Lots and lots of business will be there for pharmaceutical and bulk drug. So therefore, chemical engineers, electronics and communication engineering students and civil engineering students, there is a positive things will happen to you. But that positive things also will happen from 2021 first quarter, not 2020, because it will take 6 months time to get all the things back. Therefore, health infrastructure development projects, and cloud infrastructure projects. And fourth one is pharmaceutical and bulk drug industry. These four sectors definitely will grow, but that growth will start after 6 months only. So there is a positivity from this particular thing. And offers, how you can find out in these sectors, don't worry. The infrastructure budget releases immediately. Immediately, that will be a big news. And so many companies will start giving mails to you. And one thing, if you are not in CoCubes platform, I request you to be in CoCubes platform, because CoCubes is the agency. They are having tie-ups with all manufacturing companies, all infrastructure companies. If you are not in CoCubes platform, try to be in CoCubes platform and complete the CoCubes assessment. It definitely going to give you lots and lots of information relating to the core opportunities. So come back again. Mass off-campus from the IT sector may not be there. So therefore, you shift your career objectives. And the next point is students with industry-oriented certifications like Pega, like Robotic Process Automation, Salesforce, ServiceNow, OCJP, all these are all going to play a vital role. All these students who got the offers, so don't waste your time. First, concentrate on your major project. Concentrate on developing your programming language skills. Third, do one certification course before June 30th. Either in Pega. Pega is little costly. You can do that to Talent Sprint or Salesforce or ServiceNow, RPA. So these are all the certificate courses. Or maybe go to Coursera. In Coursera, so many useful certificates are there. So try to do some certification courses. If you are very good in C, go ahead and do BrainBank certification. BrainBank certification. So that will be enable you that the moment immediately after 2 months or 3 months, when companies started batching it, they'll ask you to revise your profile. They'll ask you to send your revised resume. At the time of sending a revised resume, you should have very good major project with you. One certification in any tool or technology like Pega, RPA, etc. And third, you should be very good in one programming language. Definitely, these three you are having. At any tough situation, you will get the batching days. And other thing is more weightage will be given to students with major and minor project in digital areas. Suppose, for example, you have done your major project in your core discipline. For example, electrical guy done in his core discipline as a major project because you can't do in digital area because your academics won't allow you. Now, what you do, complete your major project in your domain area. Another 2 months time is there. Therefore, you develop one digital project as an add-on project. You do in digital like analytics, or maybe now power analytics is very important because recently Banu sir done one very good thing on this 9 minutes power lights off situation. Like that, you can do very good projects in power analytics, or maybe you can do on IoT, you can do on machine learning, you can do on cyber security, you can do on cloud infrastructure. So these are all the digital areas. So in the digital area, so many companies are giving mini projects with used cases, like a company called Geekel is there. So they're supporting they're supporting the student community with very good user cases. So in addition to your major project, try to develop a project in the digital area. Definitely it allows you to get the major project, it allows you to get the batching dates quickly. So my suggestion to all non-CSIT students who got the software company offer in your hand, so do try to develop your programming language skills. Second, do one certification program. Third, along with the major project in your domain area, you also supposed to do a major project in digital area. So lot of time is there. So probably this lockdown will be there up to June 30th. Therefore, from April 10th to June 10th, you can take April, May, June, 3 months are there. In this 3 months period, you can finish your major project in your domain area. Not only you can finish your major project in domain area, you can finish major project in the digital area. That enables you to get the batching dates. Because for example, see, I'll give one example to you. TCS recruited 45,000 students across India from your batch, 2020 graduating batch. Now their requirement came down. Their requirement came down to 25,000. Definitely the less than that, it will not be there. I know TCS from so many years. I'm observing from so many years. So 25,000 batch, 25,000 students, they will issue the batching dates. In that 25,000, you should be there. In order, you want to be there in that 25,000, you should have a very good major project. You should have your add-on project in digital area. You should have knowledge in one programming language, or maybe skills in one programming language, and one certification. For example, a student is there, Axis student is there. He is having very good major project. He is having an add-on major project on digital, and he is very good in C++, or he is very good in Java. He has done also Java full stack developer course, and he is also having one certificate either in Pega or an RPA. Definitely he is going to get the batching dates early compared to any other. Therefore, my sincere suggestion to all of you, you concentrate first on your major project, finish it as early as possible. Probably you put a target of May 1st week, finish it. Immediately start developing a major project or a mini project in digital area, and complete one certification program. As I mentioned, Pega is very important. Anyone, no need of doing all, okay? So anyone, and develop one programming language skills. That definitely enables you to get the weightage at the time of getting the batching dates. And I'll tell you one more thing. Recently, one company contacted me. They are going to get, that is a cloud-based company. They are forcing a lot of business because of this lockdown. Because of this lockdown, a lot of cloud infrastructure companies are doing wonderfully well. So that company the company requested me for some internship support. So then I said I'll give, but they are telling they want the students with cloud infrastructure, like you should be good in AWS, or you should be good in Azure of Microsoft, you should be good in Worklite of IBM. So you should have any mini project or major project on these platforms. Definitely these platforms are going to give you very good edge to enter into the cloud-based companies. So I request all of you, try to concentrate on these things. Cloud infrastructure is going to be very crucial in coming days. So try to do some projects in this. So so many companies, they announce frequently hackathons to hire the students. Non-selects in this particular session.
I request you to concentrate, keep an eye on all these things. If any non-select or ecto-select students are there, don't worry. Try to take e-litmus assessment as early as possible. So that e-litmus assessment gives you a lot of scope to enter into various companies. So this is the impact, and this is I told you the impact, and also I told you the what type of measures you are supposed to take to face this particular situation. At this moment, I want to stop for some time. I want to take questions. Any questions is there, I'll take, then I'll go to the next slides. Girish, Narasimha Rao sir or Krishna Subbarao sir wants to share their views, unmute them.
Yeah, okay sir.
Or anyone in the any faculty member in our chat today, they want to share something, they can unmute, you unmute them.
Sir, principal sir is there, sir.
Yeah, ask principal sir, maatadtaremo sir, principal sir.
Sir, principal sir, can you hear, sir?
Yes. Absolutely.
Sir,
you want to address the students. These are all fourth year students, sir. At present, 681 students are there on the online. You can say a few words about what they are supposed to do, academics and all the things, sir.
No, only thing is, no, all my dear students, you all don't need to be panic. Everything will get settled down in very short time. If not by May 15th around or by June, looking at or exploring various options or possibilities to finish off your examinations, final semester examinations, earliest possible. Keep your certificates in your hands. Okay, I'm very confident with the seriousness with which the training and placement cell, with the lead by Dr. P. Venkatrao, certainly make you get into your career in a appropriate location. That's all from my side. Venkatrao garu, you can go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Krishna Subbarao sir wants to share something. Yeah, unmute Krishna Subbarao sir. Girish sir.
Good afternoon, principal sir, and thank Venkatrao garu giving this opportunity to talk with the students.
Sir, your voice is a bit low, sir.
Go ahead, sir. Go ahead.
As principal sir told, all the students don't be panic. We are here to help you out in all the ways from our department as well as our college side. Thank you very much.
So, Narasimha Rao sir, please. Girish, unmute Narasimha Rao sir.
Sir, just a moment, sir. Sir, Narasimha Rao sir?
Yes, sir.
You can talk, sir.
Very good afternoon to principal, sir, and the team, for Venkatrao garu, and Hachori Subbarao garu, and my dear students. And first of all, from our side, we have to thank for Venkatrao garu for completely providing the complete information. Yes, even in this kind of the crisis, means lockdown, everything, every street, red zones are there, nobody is not getting any kind of the things, but still is able to organize any kind of gathering, this kind of the things. With his Zoom software, we are to thankful to him, and also he provided the complete information what we are supposed to do and how we should not get this kind of the panic, sir. Once again, from our department of QP, we are thanking you. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, any others are there? Then we will go ahead with the question and answers. Sir, I request principal sir, you can also take some questions. Krishna Subbarao sir, whenever relevant question is there, you can take the questions and go to the question and answers. Students, it is open to you. Any sort of question relating to academics or maybe placements or anything, you can raise. Girish, organize the session by seeing the chat. Okay.
Everyone can post your question in the chat so that I will tell the panel members to answer you.
Sir, one question is, how long does it take to go back to normal situation about the crisis? Answer is, this crisis particularly will be there for the academic institutions up to May 15th. May 15th we can take a call depending upon the spread of this COVID. So at present, I think there will be an effect up to May 5th. And after May 15th also, morning principals are suggested, we are going to open in a scattered way, not in a full-fledged, all second, third, fourth years, we won't open it one day. We want to open for fourth years first, then third years, then second years. Like that, we are planning. We will come out with a concrete plan back to you. Principal, sir, you want to add anything on this, sir?
Yes, whatever you told is absolutely going to happen.
Sir.
Our top priority to the fourth year students.
Yes, sir. Sir, one more question is, can we expect online reviews and online exams from college side?
Certainly, certainly. Reviews can happen. But before that, the team, students who belonging to each team, all the team members shall gather online, coordinate each other, try to complete the project work, compile, then come with the presentation. And a team of faculty members, I will certainly... HODs will accept.
Yeah, one more question is there. That is, some mechanical companies are. One more question is there. That question is, some mechanical companies given dates like Hyundai Motors and Tata Motors. What happens to them? Definitely, we will try. After this lockdown, we will be in touch with them once again. And we will try our level best to invite them and conduct the process. Don't worry. Hyundai Motors and Tata Motors. Definitely Tata Motors is having a very less requirement. They'll come, but Hyundai, we will check it out. And if they comes to any college in Andhra Pradesh, they'll come to GVP. Don't worry about it. Okay. And one more question. What about project reviews, social hours reviews?
Everything can happen through online. We will see. For how long colleges or schools get closed?
Yes, sir. Ask him to send sand, no problem. One question, I am placed in Infosys and off campus. And they did not give any communication after the recruitment, sir. My question is, are they going to give us call letters? No problem. Just you drop down a mail to me. I'll forward it to Infosys and I'll come back to you. Remember one thing, TCS, Infosys and CTS, they never take back their offers. They may delay the schedule, but they never take back the offers. Don't worry about a mail to me. Immediately, I'll... write it to concerned company and I'll come back to you. Sir, one question, principal sir, you can answer. If this lockdown extended to long period, what is what we are supposed to do beyond June?
Even beyond June, assessments we may have to think of, even end semester examinations also in online fashion. That we will think of. We need to, point is, we need distance till June ending or July also. Okay, whatever the best way, in a staggered manner, we will see physically. If not possible, certainly everything shall turn to online.
Yes, sir. All the remaining questions are normal questions. Then we will go ahead with our presentation. As Sarita madam suggested, we can take the questions in chat also. Some faculty members are seeing the chat. You can answer. Sarita madam, Vasu sir, you can answer those questions in the chat itself. Those are all of you know the answers of that question, sir. Okay. And and comes to the next slide. Please, Girish, can you show the next slide? Yeah, this is the thing I am telling you. Already principals are mentioned about this only. And Krishna Subbarao sir also mentioned about this. Stay positive even when it feels like your life is falling apart. So nothing will happen. Most probably some time delay may be there, but nothing negative will happen to you. when if you are positive, if you are self-confident, you are having guts to face the situation, definitely the success will be with you. But it may be little delayed, but definitely you will get everything what you want to achieve in your career. Next slide, please. When the dream is big enough, we find the motivation to get through the tough times. If your dream is literally big, suppose for example, one person is dreaming to see herself or himself in Amazon. Maybe it is possible in July, but it will be possible in September or October. Once your dream is big, definitely, and you are motivated to achieve that particular dream, definitely you will get it. You can cross all these tough times with your positive energy. So, but you are not having a big dream. The problem is you can deviate. Next, please. Yeah, next, please. See, I know so many people what they are doing. You have a goal, but you are not having a plan. You want to, you are sitting idle in the house and you are not doing any assessment given by TCS, CTS, Infosys or Wipro or any other company, and you are not following the instructions of your project guides, etc. So but you want a job. That means you are having a goal, but you are not having an action plan to reach that goal. When you are not having an action plan, you are having only goal. That is not a goal, it is only wish. Wish may be possible, may not be possible, but if you are having a goal with action plan, definitely you can achieve it. I request all of you, draw your goal, write your goal, and draw an action plan. Work out accordingly. Definitely, maybe within 2-3 months, everything as principal sir and other faculty mentioned, everything will be set within 2-3 months. But you should not leave your goal. And you should not leave the action plan. You draw an action plan to achieve your goal. Definitely, you can achieve the goal. Next, please. Yeah, Krishna Subbarao sir said one thing to you all. Whatever required from college, we are ready to extend 24/7 to you. All our mails are working. All our mobiles are working. Lockdown is for only physical personality. Maybe we are sitting in the house, but we are always thinking about you and your future. So you can drop a mail at any time. You can drop a message at any time. Whatever tough situation you are facing, suppose you got a negative mail from some company or negative news from anyone, please immediately reach us. We are ready to help you. Together, everyone achieve more. That is the belief of our GVP team. So definitely, we are here to support you. All of us together, your parents, our faculty, we all are ready to achieve more. We definitely work towards that only. So we will work as a team in this tough time to come out as quickly as possible from this tough time. Stay home. All the things what we suggested is not not supposed to force you, sir. You said mini project is important. Immediately, I want to go to somewhere to do mini project. Or you said internship is very important. So it is not like that. Like today meeting only. Until this lockdown and proper instructions from the government authorities, don't come out from your home. Stay home. Stay safe. Stay positive. And one more thing is there: stay productive. Don't sit idle, right? So stay home, stay safe, stay positive. Stay productive means write your goal, write the action plan. As I suggested, try to develop your programming language skills. Try to do some certifications. Try to do some mini project and add-on projects. And a very important thing is try to build up your resume in such a way. In the lockdown period, if something is going to be cut, after lockdown, if they want to cut some numbers, in that numbers, you should not be there. You should be always there in the numbers they want to take it, right? Next, please. So, wish you all the best. Of course, I'm not ending the session. We will take final 3-4 questions after this session also. So, remember one thing, there may be a little gap to reach your success, but you have that in your hand only. That picture I purposefully selected, so you can put that in between and you can walk down and reach your success. We wish you all the best. We pray Almighty to shower all his blessings on all of you to get your career dreams into the reality. Last slide, please. Thank you very much for sparing your valuable time and coming here. All these points are not to demotivate you. I am telling you the reality picture to you. But as all our faculty said, these are all temporary hurdles. Don't worry. Don't think deep about it. So as I suggested, do some productive things. Definitely, you people will rock in coming sessions. So now we are ready to take up any session, any question. Our final 3-4 questions, we will ready to take it up before winding up this particular session. Thank you very much. One and all. What about internships, students to get job opportunities? I'll take up this question. There are so many online internship portals are there, like Internshala. Internshala is signed an MOU with AICT also. If you are doing any internship through Internshala or maybe some other things, in my presentation I given earlier to you, once again I'll circulate mail or message to you in WhatsApp groups. What are the online internship possibilities are there? Please explore internship in that particular portals. Definitely those are all as good as physical internships, but physical internships may not be possible until September 30th. That is my wild guess. So therefore, you are the people, third year it is okay, 2021 graduates, but 2020 graduates it is not that suitable. So physical internships may not be possible for you. So I request you to concentrate on the Internshala model internships. That will be very good for you. Our principal sir, want to add anything on it?
Whatever the project online, you can proceed. That is the best way. Internshala is ultimate.
What about higher education, sir? Is there any possibilities for doing M.Tech, M.S. in the immediate academic year, or should we wait another year? Don't wait. My answer is don't wait. Immediately join M.Tech. The situation requires 2 years to recover. If you are not having any offer in your hand, immediately try to get higher education. Mr. Subbarao, sir, wants to answer that question. Unmute Mr. Subbarao, sir, please. Girish, unmute Krishna Subbarao, sir.
With the permission, I would like to add some points, sir, regarding the higher education. I request all the students, please talk to your consultants. According to my knowledge, this fall 2020 will be postponed to the next semester. Okay? Please talk to your consultants if you're going for abroad. Please talk to the professors. Then only you apply for I-20s. Okay? My kind request is that please talk to your professors or your seniors and your consultants about the higher education in abroad. Okay? Thank you very much.
Yeah. One question is that CTS internships in between, you came out because of this lockdown. They sent you from Pune. I had a talk last week with HR of CTS. So they want to give some online assignments to you to cope up with the internship. Girish will coordinate with Jitendra of CTS and I'll come back. He'll come back to you. Girish, please coordinate with Jitendra of CTS. Girish, can you answer?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Please coordinate with... you can go ahead, Girish.
Yes, sir. I will do it, sir. I will talk with Jitendra and the HR of our Cognizant, and I will make
the thing is already. I already discussed with HR of Cognizant. They are doing some alternative arrangement to you. Girish will come. within 1 or 2 working days to all students in between left the CTS internship and how to go ahead with the remaining program, he'll come back to you. And this year, that's why we intelligently made your internship projects and your major projects are not same. So therefore, there is no link of your internship project and your major project. You can go ahead with your major project, internship project, we will come back to you. And some people are posting a question like PBL assessment is not opening up. We already wrote a mail to Wipro. Tomorrow, I'll discuss with Wipro National Head Lavanam and I'll come back to you regarding the PBL assessment. Yeah, Narasimha sir wants to add something, please. Girish, unmute Narasimha sir.
Just a moment, sir. Just a moment. Just a moment, sir.
Unmute Narasimha sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, just a moment.
Narasimha.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes,
thank
sir.
You, sir. Yeah, thank you, sir. Sir, this is regarding to the higher education. This is one address for the student friends, dear friends. The only thing is, don't be panicked. I think earlier our speakers they have clearly mentioned. But my only suggestion is regarding the higher education. Whenever you observe any kind of advertisements, wherever you wish to go and join, see to please. Register that particular application, submit that application. Don't wait for any other things.
Yes.
Because the advertisement may not come later. Okay, some of the universities, some of the other kind of NITs, they have given advertisement. Let us watch this kind of advertisement and see to apply. That's all. This is my only sincere suggestion. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Sir, principal, sir, you can answer this question, sir. How MTech projects can be done?
MTech projects. there are two kinds of projects in reality. One is hardware experimental related. If you have planned experimental activity, you need to wait. If you are say online some simulation activities, there are lot many virtual labs available from IIT and other host institutes, virtual labs. Whatever the facilities available online through virtual labs, you along with your team members can proceed conduct of simulation activities. Of course, by contacting continuously supervisor who is advised, you can proceed.
Some people
one more point, those who are taking up their experimental related projects, instead of their being idle, not doing anything related to the project, they can ponder over literature survey. Literature survey can happen, exploration, similarly, some kind of documentation, project work, whatever work you have done, you can document project report format like you can proceed so that it saves time at later time.
Yes, sir. So some people are asking about Sonata interviews. You completed the Sonata written test and you are waiting for the Sonata interviews. Definitely, we already wrote a mail. We are waiting for the response from the Sonata company. Most probably, they may come out after this lockdown situation only about their schedule of interviews. Okay. At present, they were not communicated anything with us. So I'll come back to you the moment they give any communication to us. Okay. So that is about Sonata and Wipro PBL assessment. So many people are raising so many queries. Just you send all these doubts to TNP mail. The same mails, same queries, we will send it to Wipro and we will get the answers from them. Right?
Sir, what I am planning is tomorrow I want to take the queries from about the Wipro, sir. And as we have shared the Excel sheet of Wipro PJP status today, there is some ambiguity in that. Some students completed in 100%, but students are saying that it was not shown in the Excel sheet as what they have done. So what I want to take is I want to take the entire data from the students tomorrow. I will initiate tomorrow and I want to send it back to the Wipro people tomorrow. so that this ambiguity will be completed.
One student asked a question, sir, I have only one offer, that too from a startup, what to do? Don't worry, that offer will be valid. And in meanwhile, please try to participate in hackathons and try to get one more offer that will be more secure, right? You got a startup offer means you have definitely very good capabilities and qualities. Try to gather the information relating to various hackathons and participate in it and get one more offer. Meanwhile, you tell me what the startup, which startup you selected. I'll gather the information that startup is nice to work or not. Okay.
Somebody is asking about the Value Labs internships. No problem. They were terminated because of the COVID-19 effect. They won't close your offer whoever attended for the internship. Mostly they have not communicated about the future things, but they won't make you any problem for that. Yes, Infosys have taken your data regarding whoever wants to join. So they will process it as early as possible because as soon as they took the data, in 15 days, again, everything went off. So whenever the lockdown has been come, they need to rework the offer letter with your respective joining dates. So they are in the process of hiring the third years also. As you all know, they have already started the InfyTQ hiring. And they have already continued their Hackathon hiring also, they have started it. So now they are concentrating on that. But meanwhile, they will also roll the offer letters when the lockdown has been terminated. And one question is about the CoCube second assessment. Today morning, we have received the information about the CoCube second assessment. They want to start that assessment as a take-home model. So mostly, after 20th of this month, they are ready with their product about this. They are making a clear solution about that. So mostly by this month end, you may take this CoCube second assessment from your home. That we will let you know. So somebody is asking about off-campus job ratio. Till now, there is no information about any official information about off-campus job ratio. As sir told, it's only unofficial information. Whenever we got it, we will definitely encourage all the yet-to-select students to participate in the off-campuses. In the meanwhile, you need to be ready with your thing. That is our suggestion. And one more important thing that I want to know. A few days back, Dr. Harini Madam from CSE department has sent you invitations on Coursera courses. I guess you all received to your personal mails, not your domain mails, a few days back. So what Coursera has initiated is to do courses online in Coursera. As you all know, Coursera is an internationally recognized platform where so many international universities and some companies like Google and Automation Anywhere, everyone is providing their learning platform to you. For a cost, but due to this corona effect, this Coursera is providing you some free courses. So that information and that registration invitation link has been sent to all the years, fourth year, third year, second year and first year. Every student received that. So what as sir suggested, you please do some professional certificates in that. So there will be some types of courses there. There will be normal courses, there will be specializations, there will be professional certificates, and there will be guided projects. These are the four categories of courses that you will be seen in the Coursera. So professional certificate, a professional certificate nearly cost between 30 to 40,000 when you want to normally register in the Coursera. But that has been lifted for now. So you please get utilized by doing such courses, because after and in order to get you a joining letter, or even if you have a rejoining interview to you, there will be a definite question to you: what have you done in the lockdown period? How have you excelled your resume in the lockdown period? So that it will be a definite question. Not only the students who are yet to join, but also who are doing jobs now in the companies, their managing directors, their officials suggested all their employees to do the Coursera courses, which are relevant to their field, what they are doing under the projects. So that much important for you to finish any of the course which is relevant to your career and in order to excel your resume. That is very important. So when this was internationally known that Coursera is opened, every company knows that this has been opened free, and this has been opened free for colleges. So we registered. So this is only for autonomous college I'm talking about. I don't know whether the women's college or the technical campus or any other colleges have been registered or not. So we have registered for that from college, and already invitation has been sent. You need to accept that invitation under our college name. If you select any of the course to get registered, it will be a free course, and you can do such professional certificates. It will be very useful. That is my sincere suggestion. And coming to, there is a category called guided project. Guided projects are very much professional projects. We have already scrutinized them in the Coursera. For example, if you take embedded systems, or if you take IoT, or if you take machine learning, if you take Python, there will be a category of type, learning type or learning mode, it will be there. So in that you select guided projects. All those courses which comes under the guided projects are sincerely suggestible to you, so that you can do some very good ongoing technological projects now. So with that, you can improve your resume that you have been had a certificate. For suppose if you go with IoT, which is a professional certificate provided by Google Cloud, a Google Cloud logo will also be on your Coursera certificate. If you do IT, Google IT automation using Python, Google trainers is directly training you that course. So that is a very good thing for us. This is the very good time for you to excel your thing, and you can complete your skills with that. So that is my suggestion to everyone. Yeah, TCS remote internships. Yes, we have already sent the data, and for all the TCS remote internship students, I guess everyone completed their Blue Prism Foundation training course, because that is very much important for each and everyone. As they are expecting all the TCS joinees to complete the foundation course. Whenever you got joined immediately in the TCS, they will encourage for you to do the Blue Prism certification, which is nearly $200, which will be given an offer to you for all the TCS selects, as Blue Prism has make an MOU with the TCS. Sir Venkatrao, sir, I have unmuted you. Sir.
Don't worry about GGK, DXC, all these are going to validate your offers. Don't worry about anything. Just as we mentioned in our presentation and talk, develop your programming skills. Two, do some certification courses. Three, complete your major project and academics in time. Four, try to do add-on project. These are all enough. You will get definitely offer batching dates from all these companies. If any problem is there, we are here to support you. Don't worry about it. Okay. Right. With this, we can end the session. Thank you very much, Principal Sir, for sparing your time and joining with us. And Narasimharao Sir, Krishna Subbarao Sir, all other faculty who joined us in this particular session, we are very much thankful to you. Students, don't worry about anything. So we are here to support you. Together, definitely we will rock in all companies' placement offers and everything. Thank you very much. Have a nice day ahead. Stay safe and stay home and stay safe. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for all the participants. So please utilize the key points what sir explained to you. And we will reach out with your exact queries. Thank you very much.
We are planning to conduct some webinars from company experts to motivate you. Frequently, we will every week one or two webinars will be there from the company experts. Please try to utilize that opportunity as much as possible. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I am ending the session. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you all. Everyone. Bye-bye. Thank you.